Thus, we have seen that in the previous video that integral minus L to L f of x dx, the value of that integrand is depending on whether the function is even or odd. If it is even, means we are getting 2 times integral 0 to L f of x dx, and if it is odd, means we are getting a 0. So, in order to find the Fourier series for a function, for a given function f of x, then first, if you want to check, means whether it is even or odd, it should be a better option for us to find out the coefficients. Because suppose the given function is an odd function, then what and all coefficient should be equal to 0. So if there is going to be an odd function, means our a naught and an both values should be zeros. And conversely, if the given function is an even function, then only one coefficient, that is bn alone, should be 0. So no need of finding all these coefficients a naught, an and bn. Just check whether the given function is odd or even. It should be very easy. So this finding the Fourier series for even function will be a Fourier cosine series, and the Fourier series of an odd function is a Fourier sine series, because a naught and an both values are zeros. So only sine term will be there. I repeat, for an even function, its Fourier series will contain a naught and an Fourier coefficients with bn equal to 0. But in the Fourier expansion of an odd function, a naught and an value should be 0. Only bn value should be there. Second thing we want to note is, the Fourier coefficient of sum of two functions. Suppose f1 and f2, two functions are given, and we want to find the Fourier coefficients or the Fourier series of f1 plus f2. Then how it can be found out? This note says that first you find the Fourier coefficient of f1, then you find the Fourier coefficient of f2. If you are adding these two, that will represent the corresponding coefficient of the function f1 plus f2. Similarly, if a function f1 is given and a constant c is given, then if you want to find the Fourier coefficient of cf, again we want to do the same. That means first we want to find the Fourier coefficient of f1, and then you multiply that with c, we will get the Fourier coefficient of the function cf.